There's currently a paradigm shift in the way that psychopathology is being conceptualized. Many people think of mental illnesses the same way that you think of physical illnesses, that they're dichotomous. Either you have them or you don't. This is also the way that the DSM-5, the Manual for Diagnosing Mental Illnesses, operates. However, there's a growing number of psychologists who think that there are some inherent faults within this system. In response to some of these faults, three-dimensional classification systems have been created. These are the RDoC, the MMPI, and the Psi-5. So what are these faults? Well, first of all, inter-rater reliability is very low for the current dichotomous understanding of mental illnesses, as low as 40%. This means that one person exhibiting one set of symptoms has a 60% chance of going to two different physicians and coming out with two different mental health diagnoses. There's also extensive comorbidity or co-occurrence of mental disorders. Most people who qualify for one mental illness diagnosis have one or more additional diagnoses. This suggests an extent to which the division between mental disorders is arbitrary. There's also low construct validity for existing syndromes. So think of a syndrome such as depression. There's a lot of symptoms that make it up, and these symptoms don't correlate highly with each other, meaning that they're measuring separate things. This is evident all throughout the DSM-5, with many different constructs all being diagnosed within one label. And I think lastly, and probably most importantly, these diagnostic labels are poor predictors of outcomes, which in turn inhibits research, and maybe one of the main reasons why we haven't seen any real progression in the field of psychology in the past two decades. When we're basing all of our research on these faulty variables, we just can't expect to see real progress in the field. This is even more evident when considering the short screening measures that are often administered at primary care settings. So in response to all of this, we created the Minnesota Behavioral Health Screen, or the MBHS, which is based on the MMPI's dimensional understanding of psychopathology. The MMPI breaks down psychopathology into distinct core components. We chose to examine 9 of these core components in the MBHS, and we chose those 9 because they're the 9 symptoms most often presented in primary care settings. These are anxiety symptoms, depressive symptoms, and cognitive symptoms. Data collection is already underway developing psychometrics on the MBHS at MAHEC, a primary care setting in Asheville. We hope to implement the MBHS as a reliable, valid, and dimensional screening tool for psychopathology in primary care settings. We like to think of this as translational science, that we're taking some of the leading psychological research in the field and using it in an applied and practical way. Thank you.